Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound for Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at the Mobile Music Platform Editor. In the previous video about the Mobile Music Platform, we created this Mobile One PD patch, which simply has a frequency and an amplitude slider. So it's quite a simple app. And we loaded that onto Mobile Music Platform and deployed it using the PD controls. In this episode, we want to look at the editor. Mobile Music Platform, just to remind you, is the information about it is available at this website. Just Google Mobile Music Platform, and it has links to the Mobile Music Platform editor, which we're going to use. You can download and you can download the Mobile Music Platform app for your mobile device. So when you open up the Mobile Music Platform editor, you get a window looking very similar to this. This grey area represents the screen, and we can add some graphical user interface devices to it, which we can then connect to our PD patch. In the Add menu is a list of all of the different types of controls you can have, sliders and dials and labels and buttons and toggles and all sorts of things. One of the good things about this editor is that there's a wider range of graphical user interfaces than are available natively in PD Vanilla. So for this one, what we'll do is we'll use one of those ones which is uniquely available. And this is an XY slider. So it appears when we click on it on the display, and we can make it as big as we like, and we can reposition it anywhere on the display. I'm going to make it pretty big, covering an area almost square. Let's sort of center it like so. And so this will appear on our display. The next tab is for properties. There's the color it's going to be normally, and then the highlight color. I'll leave those as default. This address is very important, slash my XY slider. You can change the name of this particular object that's on the screen. I'm going to use this default name, it's fine. But we'll need to remember that because we need to use that in our PD patch to address the data that's coming from this particular patch. Now, because I'm doing something very simple with just a single XY slider to control my frequency and amplitude, this is about all I need to do for this particular patch. So I'm going to save it. And let's call our previous one Mobile One. I'll call this Mobile One as well, mobile1.mmp. So the MMP, Mobile Music Platform, is the extension for the interface file. So I'll save that there. We need to make some changes to our PD patch in order to accept the data from the interface. Most importantly, we need to use a receive object, and there's a special message which is going to be sent by Mobile Music Plat called from GUI. So we receive that data, and all the data from Mobile Music Platform will come into our patch through this receive object. It comes in as a list, and so we need to route that list in order to break it out. So every time we use a route, it's going to take an object off the beginning of the list and then send us the remainder of the list. So that will get rid of that first list object. Then we need to route it again to get the particular arguments. We've only got one controller in this, so it's my XY slider. So this name here needs to match the address of this object. So that will now separate out that from anything else, even though in this case there isn't anything else. Now the XY slider, of course, has two values, the X orientation and the Y orientation. So that's still going to come out as a list of X and Y objects. So I'm going to unpack that It's got two outlets. So we're going to get our X value appearing out of here, and we're going to get our Y value appearing out of here. At this stage, I can actually do some testing, even though it's not on the thing. I'm going to resave this file back in the mobile music platform editor. I go back to documentation for this one, and there's a very important field here that I need to complete, and that is, what's the name of the PD patch which is going to be associated with this? And my PD patch, in this case, is called mobile1.pd. So I can tell it that. All right, so we're almost there. I can resave this. If we want to test this before we get it onto our mobile device, the mobile music platform developers have provided a patch which, if we have it open, will act as if it was on the device. And I've got that open here. I'm going to bring it onto screen. It's this PD wrapper object. And it basically takes messages from the MMP file and passes it to the PD file. So just remember that this needs to be open for this testing to work. I'm going to move it off screen again. So if we go back to the mobile editor, and if we go to lock this time, then when we move things on our mobile music platform editor, you can hear that they have corresponding effect here. Now, the important thing to note is that the numbers come out at the bottom here, and you can see that the range 0.45 and 0.095 indicates that the range that's coming from these XY sliders is always between 0 and 1. So for our amplitude, that's kind of fine. So we've got X and we've got Y, so I think I'm going to use X for amplitude. So that can directly go into our amplitude, that's no problem. But the Y axis from 0 to 1, what we will want to do is to multiply that by 127 to put it into the MIDI pitch range, then take that up to the MIDI frequency, and let's do that again. And now we can see that the values are appearing here, and for volume and things, so that's all great, and it's really good to be able to test that before we get it onto our mobile device. So I will just make sure I save both of those, the MMP file and the PD file, and so now it's time to get that to our mobile device. I'll be transferring that to my iPad, and so for that I'll use iTunes, file sharing, mobile music platform, and I need to find those files, which are here. So there's the mobile one and the mobile one dot MMP and the dot PD file for the GUI interface and the PD file. Copy them across. Because I have previously had a version of the mobile one PD file, it's asking me if I want to replace that, which I do. Okay, so now it's time to turn to my iPad. I've got the mobile music platform app running as we had before, and these are all the files which are here. I can say done, we can go back to what we had earlier. If I get out of it, you can see, close it, mobile music platform, open it back up again. If you recall, the show all files, the file viewer allowed us to see the PD patches. In this case, we might leave that off because we really want to see the GUI patch. There it is, the mobile one MMP. When I go to that, I get my XY controller. I can click in there. Magic, it works. So I get pitch on the vertical axis and volume on the horizontal axis. And so there we have our patch running on the mobile device. As before, if we show all files, we'll also see that the mobile one PD patch shows up as before. This time, it still works with its local controllers, but it's not quite as useful as with the large control, and now we've got all of our receive and route and pack objects that were required to get the data from our GUI. So that's running now on our mobile device, and we can take our PD patches with us wherever we want to go and use them on stage in our performances and keep them in our pockets to play as we're traveling around. So give that a go, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.